Hi friends, this is Bijoy Pulipra. I am a company secretary and insolvency professional practicing in the area of corporate and insolvency laws. In this video, today we will see the Companies Amendment Bill 2020, which was placed before the Lok Sabha on 17th of March 2020 by Nirmala Sitharaman, Honorable Finance Minister and Minister of Corporate Affairs. In this video, we will rush through the amendments which are proposed in this new amendment bill 2020. Before that, two words about the Companies Act 2013 and its predecessor Companies Act 1956. Companies Act 1956 got replaced by the Companies Act 2013 in the year 2014 beginning. At the time of replacement of the Companies Act 1956 with the Companies Act 2013, there were not much rules and regulations under that act. The Companies Act 2013 came with a lot of rules under it, which had given the powers to the bureaucracy to make amendments as per the requirements. This has resulted in numerous amendments and many notifications and circulars under the Companies Act, which made that law very complex. After 2013, there were several amendments. In a year itself, there are many amendments. And this one, Companies Amendment Act 2020, is the last one in the row. So in the we will see in this video what are the basic proposals which are placed in this bill before the parliament and what will be its outcome. So as we all are aware, when Companies Act 1956 got repealed, the chapter regarding the producer companies were retained even under the new act. In the Companies Act 2013, there were no specific provision for the producer companies. And the previous Companies Act 1956 provisions were continued to apply in the new under the new act also. In this new amendment bill, it is proposed to include the include a new chapter for the producer companies without much changes. Almost all the provisions are retained as such in the Companies Act 1956, and there are no major changes with respect to the producer company. So a new chapter will be introduced in the Companies Act once it is passed by the Rajya Sabha and got assigned by the President of India and became an act. And there are certain amendments in the offences also. As I had mentioned earlier, 2013 Act came with a lot of stringent provisions, and most of the sections contains provisions for the imprisonment along with the penal provisions. Slowly and gradually, all these criminal provisions have been eradicated. And as a part of decriminalizing the Companies Act, and the effort is also there in this new amendment bill also to further decriminalize the provisions of the Companies Act. As a part of that, they had removed the entire penalties for certain provisions. That means certain acts of minor nature will not be having penalty. And in few sections, they had removed the penalty provisions, like imprisonment has been removed fully and only monetary penalty has been retained. And thirdly, it reduces the amount of the fine payable for certain offences. So when it comes to producer companies and startup companies, they have been given with a 50% relaxations in certain penalties and offences, and made it in line with the OPCs and small companies. Earlier, only OPCs, one-person companies, as well as small companies, were able to get the 50% penalty for certain offences. Now, the producer companies as well as the startup companies will also be eligible to get that. And apart from that, it limits the maximum penalty to 2 lakhs for a small company or a producer company or an OPC or a startup. And the per director penalty cap has been fixed at 1 lakh rupee for a defaulting officer. And under the new companies bill, it is proposed that direct listing of certain companies can be allowed in foreign jurisdiction directly. Right now, it is not possible for the Indian companies to directly list in foreign browsers. This bill proposes for a direct listing of that certain companies in foreign jurisdictions. That is actually a very welcome move. And it is proposed in this new bill to exclude certain companies which are dealing with a specified class of securities from the definition of the listed companies. what kind of securities and what type of companies, all those things will be defined in a rules which will be proposed. Right now I am not able to comment on that kind of information, which will be eventually will be revealed in a new rule. And other major thing is that executive directors of a company are able to draw remuneration even if the company is not making profit or there is profit is inadequate. That provisions were not applicable for non-executive directors and independent directors. This bill proposes for bringing a parity between executive and non-executive directors with respect to that matter. That means non-executive directors as well as independent directors will be able to draw remuneration under the provisions of the Act even if the profit is inadequate. And Section 90 of the Companies Act deals with beneficial shareholdings. As per that section, any shareholder who is holding more than 10% share capital of the company have to give certain declarations to the company. There were no exemptions before. Right now, central government can exempt any class of persons from that declaration. What is the classification, how the discrimination will be brought in, all those things will be in a separate notification or a separate rule, which we have to wait and see. And as per the provisions of the Companies Act, again, whenever there is a board meeting minutes or board meeting resolution regarding the granting of a loan, providing of a security, giving of a guarantee with respect to a loan, the company have to file certain resolutions with the registrar of companies. These provisions were not applicable for the banking companies before. Now that benefit has been extended to non-banking financial companies and housing finance companies, that means those companies are also not required to file these board resolutions with respect to the loan with the register of companies. And corporate social responsibility is a buzzword where you can hear that word in every nook and corner wherever corporate laws are discussed. This corporate CSR is a mandated under Section 135 of the Companies Act. The certain class of companies having specific turnover or specific net worth or specific profit will fall under the brackets of the corporate social responsibility or CSR. Those companies will be able to, will have to spend around 2% of their average annual turnover for the last 3 years for a specified that activities as mentioned in the schedule of the Section 135. Those companies have to specifically constitute a committee called a CSR committee, and they have to follow the guidelines and the CSR policies. Right now in the Companies Act, there is a small amendment in that stating that the liability towards the CSR is less than 50 lakh rupee, then the company does not have to separately constitute a CSR committee. That means it can be even delegated to a director or it can be taken at the board level itself. So that requirement of CSR committee is going to be done away under the Companies Act by this amendment. And the other major amendment proposed with respect to the CSR is that whenever there is a spending happening from the part of the company for the CSR, and that their company is spending some excess amount towards the CSR, earlier they were not able to set it off or carry forward it to the next financial years. Right now, the bill proposes that any excess amount can be set off against the expenditure of the subsequent years also. That is also a very welcome move because companies does not have to restrict their activities for a particular budget, because they can spend and later on avail that benefits in the upcoming financial years also. That is really a very good amendment proposed. And as of now, only listed companies have to file the periodical returns with the Register of Companies and Securities Exchange Board of India. There is no requirement on the unlisted companies for doing that. In the bill proposes that unlisted companies there will be a certain class of unlisted companies which have to file the periodic returns and complete the auditing on a periodical manner. What kind of companies, what are the criteria for selecting those companies, everything will come in due course and as a separate rules. Other last one is that the bill proposes to constitute more benches of the NCLAT, National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, which is an appellate authority to National Company Law Tribunal. In different areas. Right now it is in Delhi and it is getting constituted in Chennai also. Recently it got inaugurated. We can expect that more benches will come up in other areas like Mumbai, Calcutta and all, which will help us to have a more faster resolution processes with respect to the insolvency and corporate litigation and other matters. So these are the basic amendments which are proposed in the Companies Amendment Bill 2020, and everything is actually really good for the corporates, and hope it will help us to have a better ease of doing business in India. Thank you for your patient listening. Thank you very much.